crocodile?
Yes. What animal are you most afraid of? For me, it's a crocodile with its big jaws. My concert today is all about crocodiles. My first selection is a poem called The Crocodile by Gareth Lancaster. Today I saw a crocodile. It sat and stared at me. I didn't run. I didn't shriek, in case I was his tea. No move I saw the snapper make. His jaws remained tight shut. While sweat poured down my forehead, I heard rumbles from his gut. I've been in worse predicaments, but only in my head. Like wrestling with big brown bears and monsters from our shed. But feeling brave, I shuffled close to see his scary jaws. The crocodile was not impressed and flexed his giant claws. The beast prepared to eat me up. He snapped, he snarled, he blew. I just stood and tapped the glass, 'cause the croc is in the zoo. Now let me share with you about another crocodile. A terrible crocodile that eats little children. My next selection is a section from The Enormous Crocodile by Roald Dahl. Sooner, two boys and two girls came along carrying baskets of food. They were all from one family, and their mother had said they could go out and have a picnic together. "Which table shall we sit at?" said one. "Let's take the table with the lovely flowers on it," said another. The enormous crocodile kept as quiet as a mouse. "I shall eat them all," he said to himself. "They will come and sit on my back, and after that, I will swizzle my head around, and after that, it'll be squish, crunch, plop." Suddenly, a big, deep voice from the jungle shouted, "Stand back, children, stand back!" The children stopped and stared at the place where the voice was coming. Then, with a crashing of branches, Trunky the elephant came rushing out of the jungle. "That's not a bench you're going to sit on," he bellowed. "It's the enormous crocodile, and he wants to eat you all up." Trunky trotted over to the spot where the enormous crocodile was standing, and quick as a flash, wrapped his trunk around the crocodile's tail and hoisted him up in the air. "Hey, let me go," yelled the enormous crocodile, who was now dangling upside down. "Let me go, let me go."
"No, I will not let you go," Trunky said. "We've all had quite enough of your clever tricks."
Then Trunky began to swing the crocodile round and round his head. First, he swung him slowly. Then he swung faster and faster and faster still. Soon, the enormous crocodile was in a blurry circle going round and round Trunky's head. Suddenly, Trunky let go of the crocodile's tail, and the enormous crocodile went shooting up in the sky like a huge green rocket. Up and up he went, higher and higher, faster and faster. He was going so fast and so high that soon Earth was just a tiny dot miles below. He was on and on. He was far into space. He was past the moon. He was past stars and planets. Until at last, with the most tremendous bang, the enormous crocodile crashed headfirst into the hot, hot sun and was sizzled up like a sausage.
Thank you, Ethan.